Morning, VC. It's Sunday morning. Glen Kellaway coming to you from the basement. Today is a sad anniversary day in the history of music. It's the 40th anniversary of the passing of Janis Joplin, one of my favorite female vocalists of all time. Maybe my favorite. Definitely one of my favorite performers. I saw Janis in 1970 at Festival Express, June 28th or 29th, and a few short months later, on October 4th, she was gone, about 2.5 weeks after we lost Jimmy. If you were a fan of music back then, man, that was devastating. Jimmy was a shock, and I think because Janis went so quickly after, it was a double shock. But I'm a huge fan. She basically became a superstar after Monterey Pop. If anybody, I'm sure most people have seen her performance of Ball and Chain on the Monterey Pop movie. If you haven't, Google it. It's incredible. Big Brother and the Holding Company. This album came out in 68 or 69. Ball and Chain is on this album. Peace of My Heart was the big hit that kind of catapulted them into national prominence. I'm sure my friend Mazzy could have a lot to say about Janis. I know he saw Big Brother and the Holding Company quite a few times. I unfortunately never got the chance. It would have been incredible to be in the San Francisco scene at that time. But I absolutely loved this album when it came out, and I still love it. This is Audio Fidelity Gold CD. And it sounds awesome. I don't have any Janis on record. I used to have the box set of all her albums, and then when I sold my vinyl, I hate when I have to keep saying that. I unfortunately got rid of that set. I'd like to get it again one day. Definitely, it's on my list to grab her stuff. So, anyway, with Cheap Thrills, I wanted to mention that last year or the year before, when that album was released, Big Brother and the Holding Company wanted to call it Sex, Dope, and Cheap Thrills, and the record company nixed that. But last year or so, they put this out. It's called Sex, Dope, and Cheap Thrills, and it's all alternate takes and stuff from the original album. If you like Cheap Thrills, you will freaking love this. A lot kind of more raw guitar breaks and just really, really well done. This is incredible. This is my go-to more than the original Cheap Thrills. So check that out if you're a fan of this album. Sex, Dope, and Cheap Thrills. Janis left Big Brother. She was managed by Albert Grossman, who managed Bob Dylan. And they tried to turn her into a solo superstar. This was her first album released after she left Big Brother. Kind of an R&B soul review, basically. Got them old Cosmic Blues again, Mama. The song we're just listening to, Little Girl Blue, was on this album. Then she was working on this album when she had the heroin overdose. Pearl. This came out posthumously. Actually, one of the songs on this, Buried Alive in the Blues, she was recording her vocals the next day on October 4th when she died, so they have the instrumental of it. Like I said, this is the deluxe legacy edition of Pearl. I like this because the second disc, Live from the Festival Express tour in Canada, which, like I said, I attended. So I'll I'll never forget that show. She was just electrifying. One of my greatest concert moments. So it's kind of a sad day. I love Janis, and she was a unique individual. Had a lot of demons, and I hope everyone who's a fan puts some Janis on today. Peace out. But something is driving me.